Welcome to Applied Bionomics Persimilis Production. Originally we had about 8 houses like this, so we were producing about 1 million per day. Now we're doing a fairly boutique type product. We're not competitive with the warmer climate countries, and so what we're doing here is a specialized product where we pick the persimilis on the bean leaves. This is the original way that it was produced in the 1930s in England, and it's still, in our opinion, the best. The main reason for this is that we have a balanced sex ratio when we pick the product before they run out of food. And so the negative side of it is that we actually pick these leaves and put them in the trays with some spider mites on them. But that's actually a good idea, because what we found is, first of all, we've never seen a situation where a spider mite infection begins from this point. And the second thing is that being spider mites, being part of the mite family, the arachnid family, they have one or two tendencies that tend to severely impact both the grower and our production. One of the tendencies is that the females, when they sense a shortage of food, instantly start to feed on the smaller males, which is a basic method of simple birth control. It makes a lot of sense in nature. In production, that's not very good, because the single most important performance criteria for persimilis is its ability to reproduce. So by picking them early before they run out of food, we end up with a balanced sex ratio, 50-50 male-female. We end up with nymphs, pregnant females, that'll walk off these leaves that you put in your crop onto your crop and basically hit the ground running. So we end up with a much faster period. The alternative is the collector technique, which is the way the rest of the industry around the world produces it. And this is by far the most popular one, and we do it as well, because we have a lot of growers who insist that they don't want to buy spider mites on their product. These collectors take advantage of the second natural tendency of persimilis, which is after they've run out of food, after they've consumed the males, or while they're in the process of consuming the males, their tendency is always to move upwards on the plant, which is a good way of finding spider mites. And we take advantage of this, as well as the rest of the industry, by putting these collectors on in a tent type situation where they climb up the strings and go up the wires into their collectors, and they collect themselves. So from a labor point of view, it's a wonderful system. The problem is that the product that we get from this, and the product everyone gets from this, is anywhere from 75 to 95% female, which is a very serious impairment from a sex ratio point of view. And so we have to really work hard to put in extra product. When you're using a vermiculite product, you have to put in a lot more persimilis. And there, even when you do that, there's a 7 to 10 day lag period. One of the things that really excites me about persimilis, it's one of the oldest biologicals that's been around, is that no matter how terrible the crop is, no matter how bad the spider mites get, the new growth that comes up is always completely clean. It's absolutely astounding. This is not the best example. We can find other times of the year when we basically take the bean plants to their death. And in the end, if there's any length of growth in them at all, the new growth is always 100% clean. This product works 100% of the time, every single time. If it doesn't work, it's because either they didn't survive the shipment, or they just barely survived the shipment and weren't able to lay any eggs, or there was some sort of interference. And typically what we're looking at are sublethal effects of chemical residues. Whenever we've found a failure with persimilis, we can always track it back, in most cases, to a chemical residue that was used with a so-called safe product. So our two points to make is, you should always buy bean leaves if you can get them for persimilis. You get a much better product. And always be wary about the side effects charts. Those are for how much and what percentage death there is. It doesn't even consider sublethal effects, which can have a 6, 8, 12 week extension on those periods. Thanks.